Thank you all for joining us today. My name is Chelsea Huss, and I am the Education Supervisor here at CRMLS. Today, we are going to be showing you the new CRMLS core product for our Matrix users, which is WellcomeMat. Our presenter, Christian, he's going to be covering several features, functions, and benefits of this great new tool. Let's go ahead and get started.
Thank you, Chelsea. Hello, everyone. My name is Christian Sterner, and I am a co-founder here at WellcomeMat. We're super excited to be providing native video support within the CRMLS network. And really the objective overall is to get video into the photo carousel of every real estate website, rather than continuing to utilize outbound links to sites like Vimeo and YouTube and other video hosts that don't have much to do with real estate. So generally the idea is, you know, the first step here is getting CRMLS members to understand the value of our tool set and making it so that you upload videos into the MLS not too much differently than you would add photography. So with that, I will get started. WellcomeMat has actually been around for a really long time. We've been primarily powering video for really large brokerages, you know, luxury level real estate websites like Dow Jones and Wall Street Journal Real Estate, luxury portfolio, et cetera. And our mission as a company is alongside CRMLS to make video the center of the real estate consumer experience by maximizing the value of video for agents, brokers, and brands. And primarily what we mean, you know, in the context of working with MLSs is, again, we want to get video front and center and have every real estate website in our industry utilizing video just like every other website outside of real estate does, instead of, again, linking out to view the virtual tour or something like that. The idea is to make video native on every real estate website. And that really starts with all of you uploading videos into the system that we're providing. So just a quick overview of what I'm going to be presenting, and I'm going to jump from slides into the actual software. Really what we want to cover is the capability of uploading, replacing, deactivating, and deleting videos within the CRMLS matrix system. That essentially includes version control, because if you need to replace a video, you just choose a new file, and everywhere where that video was found before, the new video will show up. We also have social media distribution built into our tool set so that you can reach your sphere of influence, so to speak, with each of the videos that you have in our system. We have video analytics, and so that's a huge benefit when everybody is utilizing a different host for their videos. Presenting analytics becomes very difficult because your analytics are locked up in each of your YouTube accounts, for example. We have a chaptering tool that we want to show you, which essentially just ensures that no matter how long your videos are, you're able to ensure that viewers can find, watch, and share the most important parts of your videos. And then we have compliance tools, which enable you to really save time and money when you're working with production teams, because you can essentially strip out branding from videos that otherwise are branded. And then we're pulling high resolution images from every single video at the rate of once per second. And I want to show you how to access those images. You know, if you have a soft spot in your photography, for example, you can go into your video tool set and grab as many images as you'd like. To start with, I want to talk about how you access the WellcomeMat video tool set. The CRMLS team was nice enough to provide these images for me. And so you want to enter the Recenter Hub dashboard and click on Matrix. Once you've done that, you'll go to Add Edit. So this step number one, from the Quick Modify section, you select the drop-down arrow, and then you select your listing. The note that we have is that you can add edit WellcomeMat videos to active, active under contract, coming soon, hold, incomplete, withdrawn, or pending listings. So once you've essentially selected your listing, you click on the WellcomeMat video management link, and you will enter a screen that looks like this if you don't already have a video for this particular listing. And so you're here, and you can upload any video file from any device that you're on. You can drag and drop a video file into the window. You can choose it from whatever device you're on. You can also select videos that are saved in Dropbox and Google Drive. And this is typically a huge resource for people that are working with video production teams, because they'll deliver your videos to you via one of these services primarily. So you're able to, you know, this also, for all intents and purposes, is the same exact method when you want to replace a video. And I'll show you how you access this screen again to replace the video that you've already uploaded. And so once you've uploaded your video file, you have the video will go through an encoding process, which essentially means that we're preparing that video to play on any device out there. But once you have an active video for your listing, this is what the page looks like that you are entering. And so again, we're going to show you how to share your video, the video chaptering tool, the unbrander, which is a very useful tool, our analytics system, and then also the media that you'll have access to once you have a video uploaded into our system. To replace or delete a video, you just select one of these buttons. And if you select replace, you'll actually go right back to this screen where you can again choose a new video file, upload it for your listing, and the old version basically fades away immediately. As you're uploading your video, but also when your video is active, we have social media distribution available to you. Right now, we're limiting to Facebook and YouTube, but we will be adding Instagram back in somewhat shortly. We are having some technical difficulties with their systems, but we are sussing through those as we speak. And so you'll see Instagram light up on this as well. So you connect basically to your Facebook account, and then any page that you are an administrator over, so your business pages on Facebook, you can choose that page from this dropdown. You can take the title of the video that we already have, or you can put in a new one for a better sort of newsfeed item and type in a description. You can also schedule when you want those videos to be distributed. And once you hit save, if you haven't chosen a date and a time, it will go out right away. But if you have, it will go out when you've scheduled that video to be distributed. And now you're reaching consumers and your friends on Facebook, and the people that you reach also via YouTube. And again, Instagram will be added in as soon as we possibly can add it back. You have a link to your branded version of your video here. So if you upload your video and it's branded, but you use the compliance tool, this will be the link to your branded version of your video. And this is the link to the unbranded version of your video. And so you can copy those links and use them however you'd like. And then we have analytics for each video that you upload. And so you'll have a really good idea, because we're connecting to Facebook and YouTube through the video toolset. We'll also have access to the analytics, the views that you're getting in each of those places. And as we make progress in getting syndication sites to pick up your videos, you'll be able to see how they're performing, how your videos are performing via syndication as well. So we have a date range selection tool. That's sort of the top level navigation of the analytics tool. And then you have a presentation of how your videos are performing over time. We also have our video chaptering tool, which is, again, really important just because you want people to be able to find, watch, and share the most important parts of your videos. And so we do our best to insert chapters via things like image recognition and AI, essentially. I'll use the buzzword and say AI. But basically, you have the ability to edit those chapter titles and change them as you'd like, or add new chapters as you'd like, and even delete chapters whenever you want. The short story is, this kind of solves the problem of the age-old question of how long should my video be? Because truly, if you have chapters properly entered into your videos, it won't necessarily matter if you have somebody that's very interested in your video. And then we also have these, the images that we're pulling at once per second. And again, these aren't always useful because with videos, you know, people are panning and doing things that essentially make the images that we take at once per second, they can be blurry at times, but you will get some really good quality ones too. And you can utilize our system to download as many of those as you'd like. The unbrander is very descript because essentially what the tool enables you to do is if you get a branded video from your production team, you don't have to ask for a branded and an unbranded version of every video that you get through your production teams. You can get a branded version of your video. And as long as the branding is in the beginning and the end of the video, you can just select a new start time by dragging and dropping and a new end time by dragging wherever you would like it. And then you can just process that video. And now you have an MLS compliant version of a video that was otherwise branded prior to the use of this tool. That's really the presentation of the tool set. And just to kind of give you an idea of what it looks like in real life, this is the tool set as shown in the presentation. You have the chaptering screen. Again, if you'd like to, you know, edit this and say, or better yet, this one, and hit save. And now that's basically the new chapter title for that scene. And you can see the markers in the video. The unbrander is found right here. I don't want sound to happen, but let's see what happens here. So if I just want to select a new end time, you can see the visual reference here in the tool and a new beginning. I can click preview now, and it will basically present the video from here to here. And when you have what you're looking for, you just hit process video. And essentially, it's just producing a unbranded version of your video. This video doesn't have a ton of analytics, but this is what the analytics page looks like. You can select a new, you know, a new date range and click update. And the other thing I should have mentioned long ago is that on each of these screens, you have a video tutorial at your disposal. And so anywhere where you find yourself in this tool set, you can click help and watch a video tutorial so that you don't have to ask for help how to use these tools. We have a video tutorial that's prepared for you and ready for you to watch at any time. And then this actually, we're going to keep increasing the types of media that we put on here. For example, we create a teaser version of every video utilizing the chapters. So we're basically saying, okay, we have a 3-minute video with 10 chapters in it. Now we can give you a preview version of that longer video where we're just running 2 seconds of each chapter. And so you'll see more and more things hit this media page. But if you want to download images from your video, you essentially can just select them and just download the video files to your machine, or just clear your selections and start over. So that is pretty much all we've been doing with our lives here at WellcomeMat.
Thank you for going over that with us. We do have 2 questions, and they asked, can this be used for a video we create on our phone if the resolution is high enough, or does this need to be a video that was taken by a professional?
Actually, the idea is to be as flexible as possible. So you are always going to get better marketing performance for a video that was professionally created, unless you're like a great filmmaker yourself. However, we are not dictating what types of videos you create. The idea is to essentially give you the ability to upload whatever videos you have and sort of let performance speak for itself.
Perfect. Thank you. The next one, can we make a video from still pictures?
You can. So basically any video format that can be uploaded to YouTube can also be uploaded to WellcomeMat. And so if you have like the Ken Burns slideshows, for example, you can upload those. However, I will say, with the objective of getting videos into the photo carousel, sometimes it can be a little daunting for a consumer who just looked at the images to then see a video with those same exact images in them. But again, the idea is for us to be as flexible as possible and accept videos in whatever format that you have them.
Perfect. We love that. Thank you. Thank you again, Christian. Do you have any last words?
Thank you so much for coming. And we're really looking forward to the outcome of people using this tool set.
Us too. Thank you so much. And thank you, everybody. And I hope you enjoy the rest of your week.